like it or not, Wayland is becoming the default on more and more Linux systems. Now, it's taken some time. Frankly, a bit more time than it really should have, because there have been some issues, some of which were legitimate. Others are just blatant design oversights that never should have been problems from the start. But every single day, little steps are made and we get closer and closer and closer to the full Wayland future. And recently, even the world of Raspberry Pi OS has decided to jump on board. Now, there have been a lot of posts about this happening, and a lot of them are kind of confusing details that are going on. This was announced in the very boringly named A New Release of Raspberry Pi OS. And as you'd probably expect, this is a title or a title style they have used many, many, many times, usually qualifying with like, oh, this is the Bullseye release or the Bookworm release, things like that. But, come up with something better for your title. Makes it a lot easier to find them. Now, defaulting to Wayland isn't a new idea in the project. It was first considered 10 years ago. Now, if you're one of those people that look at Wayland and say, oh, Wayland bad, Wayland sucks, this doesn't work, that doesn't work, why would anybody use Wayland? It's so bad. Wayland today is basically perfect compared to Wayland 10 years ago. For context, on Fedora, they started defaulting to Wayland on GNOME in 2016, 8 years ago. Back then, it was fine for developers to dog food, right? Like, it was functional, applications weren't, like, crashing and things like that. But it was not usable for the average everyday person. Let's not even talk about things like accessibility, which are still a problem today. I like to talk about screen capture. So, you know how we do all of this through desktop portals? And portals, I believe, did exist back then. But this whole idea of doing screen capture through the desktop capture portal and Pipewire, that's new. Only in the past couple of years, I think like 3 or so, is that even a thing. There was desktop capture back then, but it was either a protocol that existed in WLroots or desktop-specific solutions. And this is just one thing. There is so much else that just wasn't ready yet. Just the idea that most applications weren't native Wayland yet, so most things were running through X Wayland. And they say, which I fully agree with, at that time, it was nowhere near ready to use. That's putting it lightly. Now, this swap to Wayland isn't actually an entirely new thing. They did start doing so a couple of years back. Raspberry Pi OS is based on Debian, so with the Bullseye release, they made a fun change, changing the compositor they were using from the open box window manager on X11 over to Mutter, the compositor component of GNOME. And the reason for the swap is simple. Mutter, unlike OpenBox, supports Wayland protocols alongside also supporting X11, so if there's something wrong, you can choose either side of it. And in a following update post, aptly titled An Update to Raspberry Pi OS Bullseye, they had this to say. When we released the Bullseye version of Raspberry Pi OS last year, we started using Mutter as the default window manager instead of OpenBox, and one of the reasons for this was that Mutter supports Wayland protocols. In this release, we are making it possible to run the desktop on top of Wayland as an experimental configuration for people who are interested in trying it. Now, one thing to keep in mind here is, whilst they were using Mutter, they were not using GNOME. They were using the Mutter compositor component of GNOME and then building a desktop around it, because GNOME, KDE, all of these big desktop environments are just not suitable for something like a Raspberry Pi. On the higher end ones, absolutely fine, but on those lower end devices, no matter what you do, it's just not going to be suitable. But importantly with this change, it was experimental, it was optional, you did not have to do it. This was a test to see if it was even viable on the hardware. Before going any further, please note, we absolutely do not recommend most people run on top of Wayland yet. This is experimental code, and there are many features which are not yet supported under Wayland. To name a few, taking screenshots. GNOME has a screenshot tool, but they didn't have the entire GNOME desktop. The screen magnifier, same under their solution, they did not have it. Any remote desktop application, the screen resolution setting tool, and we hope to get some of these working in due course, but for now, they don't. Obviously, this is not how it was going to be in a long-term solution. Changes needed to be made. And in the following release, based on Debian 12 Bookworm in 2023, we replaced Mutter with a new dedicated Wayland compositor called Wayfire and made Wayland the default mode of operation for Raspberry Pi 4 and 5, while continuing to run X on the lower powered devices. Now, Wayfire is a really cool project. It's kind of like the spiritual successor to things like Compiz. Now, this was a lot more exciting back in the early days of Wayland, right? Like, back before you had KDE shipping tons of different effects. Like, you have the cube here, you have burning windows, all of this stuff, and not all of this is present in KDE, and you can do a lot of this stuff in GNOME as well with extensions, but most of the things that people want are there, and I think it's cool, right? Don't get me wrong, I do think this is really cool, but it had its place in history. Now, you can turn all of these effects off if you want and just use it as a regular floating compositor, floating window manager, but Wayfire not being one of the most popular projects in the Wayland world, in the WL Roots world, it's not the most optimized solution, and when we're dealing with low-end hardware like the older Pis and the lower-end Pis, you need something that is really lightweight, that just operates as a desktop and isn't just consuming things for the sake of consuming things. We spent a lot of time optimizing Wayfire for Raspberry Pi hardware, but it still didn't run well enough on older Pis, so we couldn't switch to it everywhere. If you're doing a migration like this, there are two things you need to make sure happen. One, you don't have a giant performance downgrade, because people are just not going to care about any of the benefits they might get. If everything runs slower, system bad, system broken, give me the old thing, it worked better. Two, features that people are actually using need to be present. I'm not talking about every single little feature, right? Like, people talk about, oh, you can't do X forwarding on Wayland. You actually can by using X Wayland and just doing it through that environment. Totally fine. But amongst things people actually use that are commonly used features, they need to work, if not exactly the same way, close enough that people can migrate over relatively easily. All of this was a learning experience. We learned more about Wayland, how it interacted with our hardware, and what we need to do to get the best out of it. As we continued to work with Wayfire, we realized it was developing in a direction that would make it less compatible with our hardware. At this point, we knew it wasn't the best choice to provide a good Wayland experience for Raspberry Pis, so we started looking at alternatives. This search eventually led us to a compositor called LabWC. Now, you don't often hear people talking about LabWC because, frankly, it's just not that interesting of a project, and I mean that in the nicest way possible. LabWC is just not exciting, and that's what it's trying to be. Basically, what it is a spiritual successor to things like OpenBox. And how often do you hear people excitedly talking about OpenBox? Basically never, because it is a very, very simple compositor, a very, very simple window manager. It is a floating environment. That's basically it. And LabWC isn't trying to have things like the i3 IPC, some fancy dbus stuff. What it is implementing the WL Roots protocols and some additional protocols and just standard Wayland stuff. And that's it. It's supposed to be a simple, lightweight environment that just does that and nothing else. LabWC is built on top of a system called WL Roots, a set of libraries which provide the basic functionality of a Wayland system. WL Roots has been developed closely alongside the Wayland protocol. Using WL Roots, anyone who wants to write a Wayland compositor doesn't need to reinvent the wheel. We can take advantage of the experience of those who design Wayland since they know it best. After much optimization for our hardware, we have reached the point where LabWC desktops run just as fast as X on older Raspberry Pi models. Today, we make the switch with our latest desktop image. Raspberry Pi Desktop now runs Wayland by default across all models. Now, for those doing an upgrade of an existing installation, you will be prompted. Your Raspberry Pi has been upgraded and can now run LabWC. Explains what LabWC is here. In the unlikely event that LabWC causes problems, you can switch back to Wayfire using the Raspberry config command line tool. Ask me later, keep Wayfire, or switch to LabWC. Now, you will also have the option of going back to X11 if that's what you want. Most use cases are gonna be fine under Wayland, but there's some weird edge cases where things might be weird and X-Wayland isn't really a suitable solution. So, you know, if you need that, it's gonna be there as well. And all you need to do is mess around with the command line tool, and that'll get you to where you need to be. Now, as with a lot of things, I came across this blog post from an article over on Phoronix. And as always, the Phoronix forums are, let's just say, peak intellectual discussion. I can't even say that with a straight face. There was a comment I saw. I wish they'd work to improve the compositors of Plasma and GNOME to make sure these two most popular DEs work well on such low power devices. I'm so tired of developers suffering from the NIH syndrome that is not invented here. Now, as I was saying before, this is not a knock against GNOME or KDE or Cosmic or any of these other big DEs, which are not designed to run on low power devices. They are designed around desktop computers, around laptops, maybe phones and tablets depending on the desktop. You should optimize them. And there is a lot of issues with these desktops where they use way more resources than they ever should. And I don't understand how anybody has left the problem there. Those are legitimate things that should be dealt with. And there are issues with just general optimization where, like in Cosmic, for example, they were using 3 times the amount of RAM they should have been using because they just had a toolkit that was not properly optimized yet. But with the feature set you have on these DEs, it's just never gonna fit on such a low power device. It's not intended to be on that device. It uses effects that just don't make sense on a lower power device, and it's always going to be a worse experience than using something built from the ground up to be as lightweight as possible. Optimization is good, assuming you aren't wasting all of your time doing it and just never adding in new features, but there are just things that don't work on certain devices, and that's okay, right? Like, we can talk about the fact that, oh, GNOME 20 years ago, it was much lighter, right? But go look at what GNOME did 20 years ago, and it was much lighter. It had less features than it does have today. Now, the not invented here syndrome part is even weirder to me because none of these projects are new. KDE got experimental support back in 4.11, back in 2013, GNOME back in 3.20 in 2015, and WRoots, which is what LabWC depends on, it's kind of hard to define the exact start of the project. The first commit was in 2017. The first tagged release as 0.1, that was in 2018. And then LabWC, that started in 2021. None of these projects are new, right? Like, it's not like Raspberry Pi OS is designing their own whole new compositor. They're using ones that are around. So nothing is not invented here syndrome. It's just not the desktop that you like. I am very happy to see more systems moving over to Wayland because this is more voices looking at problems. This is more people who are going to help, you know, deal with those little edge cases that are still there, because that's what most of the issues are. The core usage of Wayland is basically all there, but there's still a couple of things where they're a little bit rough. You know, accessibility is the one a lot of people talk about, but there's a lot of other things where they're just not a perfect experience yet, and there's a lot of issues with getting things implemented, and hopefully, sometime in the next 2 or 3 years, all of that is just gone. Either way, I'm still going to be running Wayland, and I know a lot of people are still going to be running Wayland as well. And hopefully, sometime soon, if you're not running Wayland, you'll give it a shot. If you tried maybe a couple of years ago, see how it is now, or maybe wait for Cosmic to be done and things like that. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, RaspberryPi link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I kind of want to buy a Raspberry Pi, and I didn't know what I would do with it.